It's finally here. It's finally, finally here. It's arrived! Already! We already, it took what, a day? We already have access to the one and only Newton's Cookbook. Let's take a look at it right now in game, okay? Super excited about this. I think this is really, really cool that in one day, Treyarch can announce and release a new feature for a game they shouldn't even be updating anymore. This game is done. It's finished. Its life cycle, its sort of classical life cycle, is over. But they've taken things one step further and have brought us Newton's Cookbook. So, when you jump into Newton's Cookbook, this is the first thing you see, just here. It says, "Discover the alchemical secrets held inside Newton's Cookbook. Within this ancient tome are secret alchemical recipes that allow you to take certain types of gobblegums and distill them into a different type of gobblegum." So it's exactly the sort of thing that we were expecting it to be. And it says, "Be aware, Newton was a crafty alchemist," and the pages seem to shift with time. "Each day, you'll find new recipes have revealed themselves, replacing those previously unearthed." So, the thing that's really interesting about this is that this sounds like Treyarch are going to use the fact that it changes over time to have, like, certain special days where maybe you'll be able to get a Pergaholic really easily. Maybe you'll use, like, a really, really boring gobblegum and you'll just get a Pergaholic and it'll be really, really straightforward. And other days, it might be a load of recipes that you don't care about, but they're going to try and keep you sort of coming back to the game and checking on it over and over again so that A, you're playing the game a load, and B, you're keeping updated with which recipes are available. I think that that's the idea that they're going for. So, seems very interesting. Let's take a look at exactly how it works now in the game itself. People are saying, "Rip, no sound, let me just check." And you'll just get a Pergaholic and it'll be really... Seems okay to me. Seems fine to me. Chat, you're trolling me right now. There's definitely game sound. Checking on it over and over again. There's definitely sound. Okay, so what we're going to be doing is we are going to get this image off the screen. So let's close Photoshop. We don't need that open. Let's close all those windows as well. And there goes the image. So obviously, just in Black Ops 3, as you do, pretty standard stuff. Let's go to Newton's Cookbook. So we've got distills. Distills are used to activate alchemical recipes. So if we do the free one, just as an example, let's see what it does. Free. There we go. So that gives us some distills. Okay. You must activate 3 more recipes. So we've got 30 distills right now. Oh, I've also got something on my screen that shouldn't be there. Hold on. Let me get rid of that. That's this thing. There we go. Sorted. And I can swap back to this. Looking good, I think. Good stuff. Yep. Okay. So let's spend some of these 1,000 COD points that I've got right now. Let's do that. Let's give that a go. So I'm going to get 3 more distills, or 30 more distills rather. Okay. Is this just a faster way of doing it? 200, 400? Yeah. So you don't actually save any money by getting the bigger pack, which I guess is a little unfortunate. Someone said no sound again. Let me check. I think. There's definitely sound, you trolls. So we've now got some distills. So let's see what we can do with these, okay? 9 burned out for 1 Pergaholic. Really? Okay, that's interesting. Let's see, let's see, let's see. So this is the page. This is the actual thing. This is what it looks like, okay? And if my mouse is on the screen, I'm sorry. Hello. Hi, guys. Mr. Mouse here. I can fix that. Give me 2 seconds. There we go. Mouse should be gone now. Don't you worry. So, it says, "Select an alchemical recipe. It will be activated to distill the displayed gobblegum." So, we've got all of the menu elements that we saw yesterday. All the stuff that we were talking about with Dereisendrache and the equations in the top left. The sort of orbits in the bottom right. The little teapot as well and the tea stain. It's all there. And essentially, it seems like Pop Shocks are ready to be distilled. Pergaholic is ready to be distilled. Okay. So there's a timer in the top right, 5 hours, 43 minutes, and 49 seconds. And it's got my distills written there as well. Okay? So... people saying no sound again. I'm going to prove you wrong right now.
It seems like...
there's sound. There's sound. There is sound. What is wrong with you, chat? There is sound, I swear. Okay. You're probably talking about game sound. Do people really care about game sound that much? Jesus Christ. I'll crank the game sound right now. Just for you. Just for you. Just for you, chat. Right, brace your ears. Brace them. It's happening right now. No, I'm not going to crank it too high. That should be a reasonable little increase there. So, we've got... purchase distills, Perkaholic. So, I want to see what happens if I press X on this. I don't want to use the Perkaholic. I mean, I don't have any, but... okay. So, the result of putting some stuff in here is going to be a Perkaholic. So, I can just get myself a Perkaholic in-game right now. I can just get one. And it looks like the way to do that is to use 20... is that burned out, I think? Activate recipe. Do I have enough? See, it says 9. So is it going to use 9 of them? Do I have 20? Let's see. If I go to my Gobblegum menu, let's just check how many I actually have right now. Yeah, okay, so I have 20. So I have 20 burned out, and it's going to cost me 9 by the looks of things. If I want a Perkaholic, it's going to cost 9 burned outs, and it'll cost 10 to distill, and I'll get a Perkaholic. Okay? So that looks like the way it works. So then if we go to Pop Shocks, for example... oh, okay, cool. So it's going to be a different recipe every day, I guess. Refreshes in 5 hours. And you've got, for example, 16 of the insta-kills here is how many I have. 2 is what it costs, and I'll get a Pop Shocks out of it, and it'll cost me 10 to distill. So let's do this, for example. Activate recipe, let's see how it looks. Hello, hello, hello. Okay. There we go. Cool. So that's the process. You've also got some extra writing on there. You've got some little sort of scribblings, Newtonian scribblings, if you will. And obviously the sketch of the diagram itself. I wonder if there's any... is there like another page to this? Like, the thing that's interesting to me is the fact that there's these two here, and then there's this one on the right. I'm assuming that that's because these are going to be rarer ones or something. What do you reckon? What do you reckon? Oh, people are saying you'll get 5 Pop Shocks. Oh. Wow. So I have 19 right now. If I do this again, do I end up with 24? Damn. Wow. I'm checking the sound again. There's so many people arguing chat right now. These are going to be rarer ones. Or... boom. There you go. You absolute silly billies. Milo, turn on the sound. Turn it on. Let's just get it all out in the chat right now. Everyone just spam a little bit. Say, there's no sound. There's no sound. Go on. Go on. Now's the time. Now's the time. I'm also going to just really quickly go to this and this. Now there's even more sound. How about that? So, if we do the Perkaholic one, let's see. So I don't have any Perkaholics. And if I use 9 burned outs, then it should give me one. Which would be amazing. That's an amazing use of old Gobblegum right now. Boom. There it is. Bingo. Got myself a Perkaholic. That was so easy. That's so cool. Like, honestly, this should have been in the game since the beginning. It just should have been. The fact that also, when you're buying the... like, when you're here and you want to buy distills, the fact that you can use Divinium to buy them as well as COD points, like, that is really awesome. Also, is it going to let me get more free distills? Can I just get more? I guess I can. Wait, if I just keep going back and forth, is it going to just give me more and more? Wait, why did it do it before and now it's not doing it again? Give me more distills. Oh, man! I wanted even more free ones. God damn it. Maybe if I... Oh, maybe it gives you free ones each time you do something. Let's see. So, temporal gift. Oh! What? Why would you ever do that? That's such a bad recipe, dude. Just look at how bad that is. There's no way. Like, look at temporal gifts. Like, what it actually does. Hold on. Let's go temporal gift, okay? Temporal gift. Where you at? Here we go. Activates immediately. It lasts one round. And power-ups last longer. Okay? One round. That's all. And if you go back to the actual things that it's requesting, let's just check, because I've actually forgotten what it was. Look! It wants my damn... My banana colada! It's taking my banana colada away from me! That's crazy. Okay, people saying you get a free one every time. I guess that's just for the first day, because it wouldn't make sense for you to spend 30, or to spend 10, and to get 30 every single time. Oh, is it every 3 recipes you get 30 free... That doesn't make any sense! It doesn't make sense for it to be every 3 recipes, because, like, if I do this again... Hold on, let's test it. If I go... Activate recipe, just because I've got loads and loads of the insta-kills. So let's activate that. So I spent 10 distills, I got 5 of the pop shocks, and then if I go to the Newton's cookbook thing, so no, it won't... It's not giving me a free one there. So if I do it again... Let's get another Perkaholic. Let's do that. Do 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 do. So I now have another Perkaholic. Sick. That's so cool. So cool. Let's check if I can get more distills now. No, I can't. And it won't give me any more free ones. So I don't know. I'm not sure, like, why it gave me extra. Let's do this again, because I don't have enough to get the Perkaholic again. But if I activate that recipe, that cost another 10. Cool. I got even more blooming pop shocks, which is pretty mental. So many pop shocks. But then, if I go back... No! Oh! Wait, so it's on a timer? What? That makes no sense. Can any of you guys figure out why that's doing that? Why would it give me... It just gives it back to you? Do you reckon the... Oh yeah, look, it says you must activate 3 more recipes. Oh, I know what it's gonna be. What it's gonna be is that today, because it's day 1, it's going to, it's going to probably only have recipes that cost 10 to distill. But what it's probably going to do is in the future, oh, by the way, thank you so much for the likes on the stream. You guys are the best. In the future, it's going to say, okay, maybe this one will cost 10 on the left. This one in the middle might cost like 30 or something. And that one might cost 50 or something like that. And so that way, you won't end up getting like the same number of distills back every 3 times you do it, if that makes sense. So that's pretty cool. I don't know. That's pretty cool. I think that's a cool way of doing it. The fact that they do give you some back, just so that you're not going to be spending all of your money on the distills. And then it's going to change every 5. Well, probably not every 5 hours. I'm assuming this has been in the game since 6 o'clock. Which was 25 minutes ago. So if it's been in since 6, then is it going to change every 6 hours? Probably not, because of the original image that said it was going to change, I think, every day. Let's check that again, shall we? Da-da-da-da-da. Each day you'll find new recipes. Okay, yeah, so it's going to be a daily thing where they'll give you a new recipe. And so I guess what I'll probably end up doing is I could probably end up just like... tweeting out what the recipes are on a certain day, and then you guys can just look at my Twitter and say, oh, okay, there's some good recipes or there's some bad recipes, and so you'll know whether you want to bother getting on and actually using it, if that makes sense. I am seeing that a couple people are saying it's just another way for them to make money with COD points, but to be honest, like, I don't think that this is going to end up being something that you're going to need to spend massive amounts of like, the distills on. maybe in the future, if they sort of make it really, really expensive to distill certain things. But the fact that we can distill Perkaholics right now, and it only costs 10, and granted it costs 9 burned outs, which is pretty expensive, but the fact that it costs 10 distills is pretty cheap in my opinion. So that's really not that bad. No, you don't have to buy Revelations as far as I'm aware. As far as I'm aware, it's basically just available to everybody. So you can just have Revelations or whatever and you can do it. So I'm going to do it again. Get myself some more Pop Shocks. And the cool thing here as well, actually, if I just spam this real fast, let's see what the sort of cooldown is. Let's just do 3 really quickly. I've got so many Pop Shocks now. Holy moly. Yes, you get free distills. There you go. That's cool. So if we go back, okay. So the cooldown wasn't actually that long. Good stuff. Voila, more distills for me. 3 distills. So do you think, here's a question for you, chat. Do you think this is too little too late? Well, not too little too late, but do you think that this is too late to really like enjoy it? Because to be honest, you can't buy the Perkaholic. Oh, that sucks, Jared. To be honest, like, I think most people are just not going to use this because they're too busy playing other games now. Like, I don't know. Are you guys still playing a lot of Black Ops 3? Should we jump in a game? Play some Vambies. I've got to put Pop Shocks on. I'm going to jump on Shadows and just Pop Shocks a load of Marguas. That's what I'm going to do. Let's do that. Pop Shockerino. 49. I had what, like 10 at the beginning? That's crazy. So yeah, so a lot of people are saying it's too little too late, and it's just too late, they're not going to use it. That's interesting. That is really interesting. Yeah, I'm on PlayStation, guys. That's why I'm able to see this right now. So yeah, we've got the Pop Shocks. Don't really care about the other stuff right now. I'm just going to be spinning for Pop Shocks. Yeah, the other stuff is just like random free stuff. That's fine. I mean, that's cool. I think that's cool. I mean, I'll earn some Divinium now as well, and I'll be able to spend that on distills and get the old train a rolling. That'll be good. Unless there's more maps. So, guys, if they released, like, not necessarily a DLC 5, but if they released, like, a remastered map, would you come back to Black Ops 3 and play it, or would you not care? Because, like, obviously with the previous games, they've remastered maps, and it's been, like, sort of polarizing. Like, some people on the community have been like, oh, this is amazing, like, remastered maps, I'm gonna play these loads. Other people are like, I don't know, I'm sort of not really interested. So what do you think?
You bear the mark. You are cursed.
You bear the mark.
You must place your hand upon the stone.
Okay, let's make sure that my audio is all right. It might be pretty loud, I don't know. We'll have to find out in a moment. Also, I am playing this right now on the PS4 Pro. I don't know if you can notice. Does it look high definition? Does it look like super HD and 4K and all of that jazz? There's a fumigator.
I'm warning you.
Sir, dude. What do you think? What do you think of them graphics? Damn graphics! Be interested to hear your thoughts. Boop. Gotcha. Max is in Despawn.
Free ammo.
In Despawn. There we go. You're not interested. You come back in a heartbeat for remasters. Interesting. Yeah, I'm getting some serious potato audio right now.
In what way am I cursed?
Why is it doing that? I think there might be something wrong with my game, because last time I played, I got potato audio, and I don't know why. I couldn't figure it out. It's like my raw sound from my game was just potato, fully. Audio is like on a VHS player, bruh. God damn. Yeah. Like, there's a reason I had the sound turned down. But, oh well, I'm gonna turn it down again. People moan no matter what I do, so I will just live with it. There we go. You dead. And you dead. Boop! Gotcha. So let's try and get a Pop Shox. Let's try and get a Magua. So we got to go through a couple of rounds and then try and get a Pop Shox and smack a Magua in the face. In the face. Yes, mate. You want a standalone COD Zombies game? Bruh. I feel like a standalone COD Zombies game would, like, it would stop them from making the game that they should be making, if that makes sense. Like, I think that just the way that Treyarch works, like, if they did a standalone, it would kind of mess things up. But I don't know. Nice thumbnail. Thank you. Whipped it up in about 10 seconds. It was amazingly quick. I had to be super speedy because I had to stream the old cookbook arena. The cookbook. The book of cook. Let's go down here. Let's try and get everything open straight out of the gate. Buzz, buzz, buzz. And you, sir. You, madam. You, darling. And is there anything else here? Did I get everything? I think so. Can't remember, to be quite honest with you. There's stamina.
Back to my old self.
Stamina. Time to kill you. Gotta go through some rounds. I can't do the Shadows of the Elite Dread because it's not soloable. You can't do it solo, unfortunately. It is not a possible. Do the Easter egg. Lots of people saying it. There's the summoning key. So, Pop Shox, please. Let's grab this while we're at it. There we go. Pop Shox. Por favor. Gimme, gimme. Gimme, gimme. That's not Pop Shox. But I'll take it. Why not? Coagulant. The best gobblegum in the game. Low key. Excuse me, Mr. Keeper. Get out of my face. Get out of here. What's my PSN ID? My PSN ID is a Mr. Ruffle Waffles. It's not actually. That's a lie. It's a lie. What's different? The Newton's Cookbook is what's different. They've added in an entire cookbook into the game. And the idea with the cookbook is that you basically take gobblegum you don't want and you spend them to get gobblegum that you do want. That's like the simple summary, I guess. Gobblegum you don't want. Turn it into gobblegum you do want. And obviously you get the ability to get sort of like random, like extremely profitable recipes as well, I presume. Like 9 burned out for Perkaholic is a deal. It's a great deal. So, oh. What? Why is that there? I mean, I'll take it, but I don't know why that's there.
That makes sense.
You are that duck. Okay, so let's see. I'm going to go to... Where am I going to go to? Where am I going right now? Jug, probably. It's probably a good idea. This way? Nope, not that way. Okay, it's canals. The canal district. Die. There we go. Very nice. Die as well, please. Can you get a shout out? Sure thing, Steven. Sure thing. They should make a remaster of Moon. Do you reckon? Because, like, a lot of people didn't really like Moon that much. They were like, yeah, it's sort of, it's quite slow and, I don't know, it's fairly large. And if someone goes down, like, in one of the excavators or something, it takes quite a long time to get to them. And I don't know. Can I do an open lobby on PS4? I'm just grinding through to get a Magua right now. That's the plan. I want to Pop Shox a Magua so bad. I want to use up one of these damn Pop Shox. It's got to be done. It's got to be done. While I'm actually here, I may as well go and get my beast mode on and kill you while I'm at it. Oh, knife, please. Knife, please. That's one thing I have noticed. Like, coming back to Black Ops 3, having played Infinite Warfare, the knifing system in Infinite Warfare is so bad. Like, it's so bad. I don't know how they managed it. It's awful. Really, 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 really awful. Right, let's go up. Let's go up on a Tuesday. Oops, excuse me. Rail. And Zapparino. Excuse me. Thank you. Let's get ourselves up here. Get that perk machine on. And try and get the stairs while I'm at it. Is that... Didn't know that? I thought you could do it from that distance. I'm sure I've done it from that distance before. Oh well, that's fine. I still got it, so it's not like I missed anything.
I don't quite remember.
Kino needs to be remastered. Not like Revelations where it's changed. You want the original Kino back? The thing is, though, if you got the original Kino back, wouldn't it be boring? Like, wouldn't you just be bored instantly? Because you'd be like, oh, it's just Kino again. I don't care. Like, what do you think? I'm interested to hear what you think.
It's interesante.
Zippity zip zap. There we go. And you. And you. There we go. I can just get out of here now. Yes, I am playing on a PS4 Pro, and this is the Morgue City News, baby.
Is everything normal?
Is everything normal? Can you have a shout out? It's your birthday. Shout out to you, James. Remaster Ascension. Okay, chat. Here's a question. What's your favorite map? Out of all the maps, what's your favorite? Because to be honest, I reckon a lot of you guys are going to say, like, Der Eisendrache, or you're going to maybe say Origins. That's my guess. Because so many people in the community, like now, if they're joining the community now, their favorite map will be, like, a Black Ops 3 map. But if they've joined the community, like, back during World at War, a lot of those people have favorites that are, like, Shinonuma, or, like, some random old map. So it'd be interesting to see what you guys think. Yes, the book is in-game. We've already used it. We've already used it. It was the first thing we did in the stream. Nostalgia plus better graphics? I guess that makes sense. Like, the nostalgia and the better graphics would sort of make you play it a bit, but would you sort of keep coming back to it? Like, when there's a new map, like, for example, I don't know. Like, if you take, for example, Revelations, right? Revelations came out, and the whole community was playing and playing and playing it so much. Because it was new, and there was so much to find, and there were loads of, like, mysteries unsolved and stuff. But I'm not sure if there would really be any, like, sort of interest, like, in that same way, if it was a remaster. It would just be like, oh, this is cool. I don't know. Someone said the Giant's their favorite map. Interesting. I prefer the original Dariz, I think, but the Giant's still pretty cool. In fact, the World at War Dariz is sick. World at War Dariz is just lovely. I love that. Love that map. Apart from the dogs. The World at War Dariz dogs are so annoying. Oh, hello. Easy does it. I'm just going to jump in here just to make sure I don't accidentally poop myself into oblivion. Alright, there we go. Let's get ourselves some jug, shall we? Let's head over there. To jug we go! Die. And through the gap. Oh, excuse me. Easy does it. And I'm slipping in a slide. Alright. There we go. People saying Kino's their favorite map. A lot of people like Kino, to be fair. Kino is like a big fan favorite. In fact, I reckon next to Origins, I reckon Kino is probably the map that the most people say is their favorite. I wonder, maybe one day I should do a little poll. I should, like, figure out which, like, your guys' favorite map actually is, because I do really think it depends on when you started playing zombies. And so many people, for so many people, the golden era of zombies is like Kino era. Do you know what I mean? It's like, that is the era when everything was perfect. Like, Tom was making zombies videos. Everyone in the community was just sort of learning what was going on. The story was in a really interesting place. Like, all sorts of cool stuff was going on back during Kino. There we go. Let's go get some weapons for myself. I might just get a CUDA. Is the box here? Oh, it is. Okay, let's spin the box. Although, if I get something bad right now, I'm kind of screwed. Oh, it's down there.
That's a really freaky looking cabinet.
That's a freaky looking cabinet. Okay, let's go down here.
No break and no bullets.
Let's give a spin. There's all the Apothecon that we translated all those months ago. Fun times. Ooh, okay. I'll take it. That's not bad at all. Not bad at all. You started day one of WoW? Well, I mean, it doesn't seem like you did, because you just called it WoW instead of World at War. Like, it's WAR. W-A-W, not WoW. Ascension is too dope. Ascension is a legit map. And it's quite easy as well, which is kind of nice sometimes. Like, you play Shang, and it's just like you're super intense the whole time. Or you play 5, super duper intense, and you just spend the entire time, like, having to watch your back constantly, and it's crazy. But I don't know. Sometimes it's nice to just have an easier map. Oi. There you go. What's that? Nope, don't want the nuke. No, thank you. No, thank you. Actually, we probably do want the nuke, because I can just speed through the rounds to get the Magua. There we go. Like, I've got Jug now. All I need is the actual Pop Shocks. Alright, let's spend some cash money. That is in plain sight. I'll take it. Why not? Thank you very much. What about five? Five is like... I don't know. I think five is alright. But I think that five, just in terms of design, there are... It's just weird, man. It's just a weird map. Like, I think it's the sort of map that if you play it loads, you probably, like, fall in love with it. But if you don't play it loads, you're probably just like, meh. Meh. You love Overwatch Gibraltar. Delivery guy plays just subbed. Thank you. I appreciate the subscription. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Where's the cookbook? We've used it. We have used the bad boy. So what we did is we distilled a load of stuff. Let's actually do this real quick. What? One, two, three. Boop. Got it. First time. Bingo. There it is. Good old Chang's Laundry. Good stuff. So it's a parasite round. So I'm going to go over here. You watched my first video today, Demolition on Modern Warfare 2. Oh my goodness me. The throwback is real. We got it. Oh, I thought we got it. We didn't get it. God damn it. Got the damn arms grace. Oh, hold on. Hold on. Bruh. Bruh. There we go. Alright. Snipe you. There we go. Where's the next one? And last one. Thank you. Max ammunition for me. And let's wait till next round. Where's the new content? We've used it. What I'll probably do, guys, is I'll use the Pop Shocks and then I'll show you guys the cookbook again. Just to make it super... Oh, I nearly spent the money just then. Go on. Take over. 500. Thank you. There we go. There we go. Got some Divinium as well. Nice. So, stock option. Bruh. Do the... Ah, nice idea. Do the ritual. I got the Magua. Good shout. Very good shout. The thing is, though... I do need... I mean, I think it has to be the next one that I get. Ooh, Insta, that's going to be really helpful. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it has to be the next thing. So I'm just gonna buy it now. There we go.
You don't scare me.
Lovely. Okay, there's the Pop Shocks. Good stuff. And let's not automatically melee any zombies. Boop, boop. Oh, I got a dead leg. Ooh, no. Oh, God. Oh, my leg. Ay, caramba. My poor leg is so dead right... Oh, no. Ah, it's so tingly. Okay, where can I go? I should probably go to the canals to get the next Marguino. Here we go. Here we go. To the canals we go, everybody. Tell a joke. Let me think of a joke. Let's think of a joke. Funnily enough, a friend of mine actually got given a joke book yesterday, and it has the worst jokes in it. Like, the worst. Just hands down. They were so bad. Oh, didn't get the box. My bad. Oh, my leg. My poor leg. There we go. Let's go down the old jump over here. Feels good to be on Shadows of Evil again. This map is actually pretty nice. Quite like it. Quite like this map, excuse me. There we go. And let's open this as well while we're at it. There we go. Excuse me, zombie. Ay, caramba! Okay. And so we're going to get the ritual. We're going to get the Magua. And then we're going to use the Pop Shocks. Just to embrace the fact that I've got 49 of the damn things. And then, yeah, we'll go back to the cookbook and do some more stuff. There's the shadows. I was gonna say the shadows key. It's the summoning key. What am I talking about? Okay. The soul ball. Just keep on walking around the Christmas tree. Do 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 do. Boop. Boom. There we go. Okay. And so, we should, I'm just going to take out those zombies, there we go, oh boy, easy tiger, okay, so we should have the old Marguino now, and I will reparino him, promptly. I think the last zombie is inside. I think. Wait, is that last zombie? Alright, so it should auto-activate, right? I'm not gonna lie. I've used pop shocks, like... Okay, that's not the last zombie. Cool. I've used pop shocks, like, once, so... That didn't work. Yes, it did. Cool. There we go. Animax ammo. Nice. Okay. Boom. Pop shocks is so good, man. Like, that's just so nice. Holy moly. Okay, hold on. People saying no sound again. Let's find out. I think. There's sound. Okay. So. I'm now gonna... Let's see. I already had one Divinium. I already got another Divinium. So probably if I go like another two rounds, I'll get another Divinium. Then I can get some more distills. And then I should be... Actually, I can use the Divinium to spin for some Gobblegum. Maybe I'll get something I'll be able to use in a recipe. Maybe. Let's see. If I just go a couple more rounds, buy some stuff as well. Generally, it's like opening doors and stuff. The game tends to give you Divinium. So let's just keep on making them sweet, sweet purchases. Boop. There we go. And there's somebody next to me. In fact, if we go all the way through here, we can get the next Magua. And we can smack that big old Magua booty. And... take it out instantly with our 49 pop shocks. So let's go up there. There we go. And get that down. And I might as well just open this up while I'm here. Excuse me, zombies. There we go. And through to the anvil we go. There we go. Boop. Open. Nice. There's the little shadow man hanging around. Hanging around. Okay, so let's go grab the belt. Just that. Boop. Very nice. Not too worried about those keepers. They can just... What? How did that not hit the zombie? Come on now. Getting trolled, man. I'm getting trolled. Getting trolled. I forgot the worm. Did I not pick it up? Damn. I tried to. I guess it just didn't... It didn't pick up when I tried to do it. That's fine. I can go through the sewers to the canals. That'll be nice and quick. Yes, all good. Yes, all good. Open the rift. There we go. Okay. And I guess it's going to do this little shebang real quick. We'll kill some keepers. It'll be all nice. There's another one. There's another one. There's the last keeper. There we go. Good stuff. So, where are we going? Canals? We're going to canals, right? Yeah? Yes. That's where I left it. I didn't leave it in Nero's, I'm pretty sure. So, it'll be in here. It's gonna be inside this little room right here. Right up these stairs. There we go. Give me that worm. Give me a worm, baby. Why were... There we go. Just had to be closer to it, I guess. I ain't used to having to go so close to them worms, man. Rest in peace. Good night, sweet prince. It was fun knowing you, everybody. Oh no! Okay, hold on. If I get hit before I go down, then that will be a rip for me. So I'm just gonna make sure I'm not gonna get hit, and then boop. There we go. So back to the waterfront district we go. Oh, let's spin the box while we're here. Why not? Why not? Might as well. I'm gonna sneeze. Ooh. Okay. Oh, that was a violent sneeze. Oh. Pain. Okay. So, where are we going? I think we're going over here.
I think so.
Lovely. Got the belt, correct? Yes. Lovely. Let's go. There's the tram. Looking lovely. Red line departing for the canal district. Red line. There's the boat. The mystery boat that everyone's been confused about for about 200 years. Those damn boats. The boxing gym. There we go. Ritual beginneth. Let's do it. Die. Nope, nothing in there. I was convinced there was going to be something in there, so I was pretty far in the damn keeper, but not today. Not today. Excuse me, zombie. Excuse me. Thank you. Sorry, bud. You dead. Apologies, buddy. Look at the summoning key. It looks so lovely. Right, there we go. There's the worm for me. There's the Shadow Man for me. And then it's the last one. Time to go get another Magua. It's time. It is time. Okay, let's see. Boop. Where's the last location? We have not been to the Footlight District. Let's head over there. You can barely hear anything. The audio quality is bad. Yeah, deal with it. There's nothing I can do. It's literally a glitch with my game. Like, people say, oh, there's no sound. There is sound. It's just that it sounds weird because my game just doesn't output sound correctly or something. It's very strange. I can't do anything about it. It's literally a problem with my Black Ops 3, as far as I'm aware. So I'm sorry, but it is whatchamacallit. It's sort of out of my control. Let's go there. There we go. Let's see if I can get all of this in one go. I never do, but let's give it a shot. Oh, that was fast. Okay. Okay. Oh, no, I went the wrong way. Oh, no, I went the wrong way. Yep. Not going to do it in one go. Oh, well. Oh, well. I tried. Damn it. There we go. Zappy zap zap. Zappy zap zap. Can I get the door? Don't know if I got the door. I might have done. If I'm lucky. If I'm really lucky, I'll have got the door just then. What do you reckon? Play some bets in the chat, guys. Did I get the door? No! Damn it! Ah, so close. That's all good. Let's grab that. There we go. And let's go put it in the thing. And then let's go pop shocks another Magua, baby! Okay, there we go. And put it down. Look at that little hairpiece. Oh, it's flying! Okay, I'm getting out there now. I was just going to be like, hey, look, it's just chilling out, looking all cute. And then, nope. Wait, you can stand on those stairs? On the banister? Whoop! Oh no, you can't stand on that one, apparently. Hold on. Hold on, I got some sleuthing to do right now, guys. Can you? Oh yeah! Huh. I'm on the banister. Alright, and now I'm getting my worm. There's the Magua. Wait, no, there's the Magua. And you dead! See ya! Toodles! Nice! Awesome. Oh, hello, there's the heart as well. Good stuff, forgot about that. So let's grab this. So I want that next Divinium. So I'm gonna keep on plowing through until it happens. I'm waiting for it. I am waiting. What's the new content? It is Newton's Cookbook. By the way, guys, thank you for 1,000 likes on the stream. Let's see if we can hit 1.5. Let's see if we can do it. Newton's Cookbook is the new content. It's the very beginning, sorry, the very first thing we did at the beginning of the stream. So if you want to see exactly how we used it, then rewind. We'll be going to it again in a moment. I've not opened that door yet. But yeah, we'll be going to it again in a moment. I just wanted to actually show its, I guess, rewards that it grants you in-game. Which is why we're using these pop shocks right now. So, I haven't opened the stairs down there, so let's just go this way. Let's go. It's me, Mario. Yeah, this is PS4 Pro. How do you want to hit the Magua? That is the beauty of pop shocks. No? It's not accessible for, like, limited people. It's for everyone, as far as I'm aware. I know that it's on PlayStation. I don't know if it's on Xbox yet, but if it's not right now, then it probably should be soon. What am I missing? Hold on. I'm missing these bad boys. There we go. Don't lay a hand on me. You're taking an exam and watching the stream. You madman, what are you doing? What are you doing?
Looks like we just got a full reload.
There we go. And two more. Thank you. Let's get that build in front of us. Lovely. And let's do the ritual. Open the Apothicon Rift Stone. Let's do it. Oh no. Don't you dare knock me off. Don't you dare. You tried. I saw that, Mr. Keeper. You tried your luck, but not today. Not gonna fall for your keeper antics. Anything on the other side? Nope, it's clear. I can run. I'm gonna run. Boom. There's Dat Boy. Dat Boy. It's pretty crazy thinking about it. How with the like the first sort of news we saw of the Shadow Man, we knew so little about him, and now we know so much. You know, all of this crazy stuff about the Shadow Man now. And about Monty. It's cool. I like it. I like the knowledge. So we should get a Magua now. Like, here. There it is. And now, the Magua is dead. Bye. Toodles. I'm fighting for the max ammo, baby. I'll fire very much. I appreciate it. There we go. So we got the free ammo. And I'm gonna kill the zombies as well. We got a nuke, so the round should be fairly nearly over. Well, fairly. Fairly nearly. What? There we go. Good stuff. I'm just slaying. And I need to make some purchases to try and get that divinium. That next bit of divinium. Come here. There we go. Let's go you. Good stuff. So yeah, let's go get some perks, I guess. So I could go. I don't think I've got that open yet, have I? Nope. Didn't open it up. And canals had jugs, so let's go where we can get some more perks. Can you please fix your game audio? No. I'm not Treyarch. Unfortunately, it's my actual game. It's a glitch. Nothing I can do. Another max. Holy moly. The box up here is not open yet, so I'm going to need to do that now. Let's do that now. There we go. Oops, wrong button. Nope, wrong. I had the button right the first time. I second-guessed myself. There we go. There we go. Let's just do that for the banter. Try and jump down there. You can't do it. I tried that so many times. I wish. Okay, so let's go up.
Is everything normal?
Is there a part here? Nope. Hold on. Hold on. Let's clear the way a little bit. Oh, okay. Hold on. Oh, no, 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 no. 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 Oh, God. They're staying in the room as well. Oh, God. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. It's fine, because I kind of want to die. But I also kind of want one more divinium. Oh, no! Zombie, don't you dare. Don't you dare. Yeah, I kind of want one more divinium. So... Ken has, please, game. I don't know how long it's going to take for me to get it, but I would really like that divinium right about now. That would be real swell. I should probably be using this as well to build more points. It's probably a good idea. Hey, wandering hand. Ratata! What's that? Double points, nice. Good stuff. Is that a zombie? No, it's a box. It is box. That is zombie, though. There we go. Okay. Lovely. So,
don't get fresh with me.
I guess that gives me an excuse to get some more perks.
Okay.
It gives me an excuse. So, I can come through here and grab myself some speed cola. No divinium yet. That's fine.
Okay,
oh,
okay.
I just ran against the wall. And let's go to get ourselves some Juggernog over here. What do I think of Infinite Warfare Zombies? You personally don't like the first map, you're waiting for DLC 2. You mean DLC 1? So, I think the first map's alright. It's decent. It's not the worst map in the world, but, oh no. Okay, that's not good. Let's, we might have to skedaddle out of here, unfortunately. So, no jug for me right now. We're playing with no jug. That's okay. That's okay. I can dig it. Yeah, I think that it leaves a little to be desired, the first map. But they'll improve with time. It's their first go. It's a good sign for a first go as well, because, like, there was quite a lot of depth there. So, it wasn't too bad, I'd say. I'd say it was not too bad. Like, a lot of people were like, oh god, it's gonna be the worst thing in the world. And it wasn't the worst thing in the world, which was positive, I think. I think that was definitely positive. Let's make sure I don't get cornered right now. I don't want to go down for no reason. It's probably going to be a zombie right in front of me in here. There is indeed. And coming out of that damn window over there. Yeah, knew it. All right, let's get the jug. A good. And quick scope the zombie. Good stuff. Is this a troll? No, 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 no. It's real. Rewind to the start of the stream. Newton's cookbook. It's happened. It has happened. We're going for one more Divinium and then we're going to be using it again. So stick around. We're going to see it in about... What is that? God damn, those things sound brutal. We're going to see it again in, like, I don't know, un momento. Not long. There's an eight ball. Let's see. We've got speed code already. Let's go towards double tap. There we go. How long do you reckon it's going to take to get another Divinium? Should I just wrap it up now? I could just wrap it up now. Double tap root beer. I don't know. If I point build a load, then like I'll be able to buy a load of stuff and then maybe I'll be able to get it. But I think it's also tied to rounds. So I don't know. I didn't know, like.
Go me.
There we go. Alright, let's just spend these 1500 on like this.
Kinda need some ammo.
No, okay. In that case, let's just wrap things up because I want to show you guys the or maybe I should keep going. I don't know. I think I should probably just use the new mechanic. Show you guys. Yeah, someone said wrap it up. I'm gonna wrap it up. I'm gonna show you guys the feature again, the mechanic. We used our pop shocks 3 times. Was it 3? Yeah, 3 times, very effectively. So that was pretty good. That was pretty good. What does double tap do? Makes you run slower. Okay. So, the new feature, to reiterate, is called Newton's Cookbook. And the way it works is that you get distills, which are just... Here it is. Newton's Cookbook, okay. You get distills, which are here, and you can buy them with Divinium, or you can buy them with COD points. Now, it's up to you which you buy them with, but I reckon, okay. So, you get your distills, and then you go to the actual recipe page here, the cookbook, and there will be 3 recipes per day that will be available to use. So, for example, today, you can distill yourself some pop shocks, 5 pop shocks, in fact, or a perkaholic, or a temporal gift, which is pretty cool. So, if we go to, for example, the pop shocks one, you can see that in the top left, I have 2 of the insta-kill gobblegums, just there. That's what the black 2 is, and it's going to cost 2 of those insta-kill gobblegums for me to get 5 pop shocks. Now, it's also going to cost 10 distills, which is in the middle there. And what I'm presuming is going to happen is every day when they change the recipes, because they're going to randomize the recipes, every day they're going to change it, and it's going to cost a different amount of distills and a different amount of the sort of base gobblegums in order to craft whatever is being crafted. So this one, for example, the perkaholic, you need 9 burned out, but I only have 2, 10 distills, you get yourself a perkaholic, which is pretty sweet, and then a temporal gift, which is the most ridiculous recipe in the world, because you need a damn banana colada in order to do it, a slaughter slider, and those things are sacred, they're precious to me, I'm not trading those things in, so I'm not going to craft any temporal gifts, but just to show you guys how exactly it works, I'll craft some more pop shocks, just for you. I've got so many of those things. In fact, you know what? Yeah, it needs an aftertaste as well. It's just not worth. Aftertaste for temporal gift is a bad trade. But yeah, so let's craft some more pop shocks just to show you guys exactly how it works, okay? Here it is. Newton's cookbook. Activate recipe. Bubbity bubbity bop. Goes in the middle. Does a little swirly swirly swirly. And then boom, you get your 5 pop shocks. So I now have 53. Ay. It's a bit nuts. Just a little bit. And the last thing to show you guys, by the way, thanks for 1200 likes. You guys are the best. The last thing is that when you're on the buying distills page, you actually get 30 distills for free every time you craft 3 recipes, which is pretty dope. So it's probably not going to be out yet on PC. You're probably going to have to wait like 24 hours or something, but it will be available on PC nice and soon, and on Xbox, I'm sure. Another thing, can I remember Liam for the winter? He's a good friend of mine. I was talking to him today. Another thing that you'll see in game is this. This is the sort of menu that it gives you when you first open it up, and it says, Newton was a crafty alchemist, and his pages seem to shift with time. Some really interesting stuff. I'm wondering if they're going to go anywhere with the story for this, because, like, Newton has not really been present in the story. The only time we've had any real indication of Newton being at all relevant is in this gobblegum, Newtonian Negation. Activates immediately, lasts 25 minutes, zombies killed fall straight up. That's about it. So people sort of thought that it was just like a joke, like Newtonian Negation, Newton, like gravity, etc. It's kind of obvious, but now he's actually a bit more prominent because his damn cookbook is in the game itself. So that's the main thing that I wanted to show you guys, really. Do you have any questions about it right now? What about PS4? I'm on PS4. So it's on PS4 right now. Please shout out, sure thing. Shout out to you, Liam. Milo Davis says, please answer me. There's no question in that message, bro. 24 hours. Yeah, it's gonna cycle every 24 hours, I presume. But right now there's 5 hours left. So in 5 hours, it will update. Oh, they updated so you get 30 every 24 hours? Are you sure? Because earlier on today, that's not how it was working when I tried originally. No, it just says you must activate 2 more recipes. Maybe there'll be a countdown if I do 2 more. They really did this, yes. So Assad says this is bad. The thing is, though, Assad, there's nothing to moan about with this system because it's just extra content. Like, Black Ops 3 is done, it's finished, and yet they're adding more ways for you to get rid of gobblegums you don't want and get ones that you do want. You don't have to spend COD points, you can just use spare divinium. I don't see a problem. You get free distills as well, so is there really an issue there? I don't think it's that bad, man. I really don't think it's that bad. Does it have new DLC? Not yet, but if enough people play Black Ops 3 over the next few months, they might release more DLC for it. So if you want to see more DLC, you've just got to play the game. That's just the way it works. Can I shout you out? Sure thing, Tanner. Shout out to you. Your brother was in one of my moon videos from Black Ops 1. Holy moly, that was a long time ago. Damn. Okay, so Jacob just said it's a 24-hour cooldown to get 30 distills. Refresh your PS4 to see for yourself. I guess maybe at the beginning when I first used it, maybe that was like the rates that they were using for testing. And maybe now it's just something that they're basically saying, eh, you know what? We're going to tune it down a little bit so that it's not too many free ones. Maybe. Yeah, it used to be 30 minutes. Now it's 24 hours. Sorry, it used to be 3 minutes. Now it's 24 hours. Okay. Cool, I thought you were studying. I am indeed studying. I am studying very hard. I was in the lab all day today. I've been writing a paper this week. It's been going well. Looks like you're playing some giant, baby. Hell yeah. You gotta grind out those gobblegums. Grind out that divinium. Did this come with Monday's update? No, it's today. It's just updated today. Okay? So, guys, I am gonna wrap things up here. Thank you for watching the stream. I just wanted to basically say this is how the system works. This is how you use your distills. This is how you get gobblegums from it. This is proof as well that you can use the damn things in game. So it's a pretty cool little feature. I think that this is really cool just seeing as it's extra free content for us. And I hope that they keep giving us more free content and new features in the future. And ultimately, like I said, if more people play Black Ops 3, then they'll keep making content for it. That's what Jason Blundell said himself, personally. He said, if you play the game more, we'll make more content. And that means if you play the game a load, they're going to make more DLC. So it's up to you guys, and it's up to me, I guess, as well, to try and keep thinking of new ways to innovate with Black Ops 3 and do that sort of thing, alongside all my Infinite Warfare content. But anyway, I've been Mr. Off Waffles. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Leave a like if you've enjoyed. Right, give me a high five. Boom, there we go. And I will see you, hopefully, in another stream sometime fairly soon, or maybe in some more Black Ops 3 news, or Infinite Warfare, or whatever it might be. If I don't see you, then have some happy holidays, and I guess DLC 1, probably, is going to be the next time that I'm making, like, a bunch of content. Obviously, I'm making videos, like, every other day, pretty much, but DLC 1 is going to be really hype, and that's coming out at the end of January, so look forward to that. Look forward to more Black Ops 3 content, and I'll see you guys very soon. Okay? Thanks for watching, guys. You're the best. Thank you for the likes on the stream once again, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.